When you add an option to a form or a report, like the Ship Via option group that I have here, it's going to display just a limited set of options for your users to choose from. Now, the benefit of an option group is that it makes it easy to select a value, since all you have to do is just click on the value that you want. And as you can see, only one option can be selected at a time. Now, taking a look at the option group on my screen, you can see that an option group consists of a group frame and a set of either checkboxes, toggle buttons, or option buttons, like I have here. But something that's really important to note is that the value that's behind these buttons is set to a number. And that's because the value of an option group can only be a number. It can't be text. So let me repeat, the value cannot be text. So even though here on my form, I'm clicking either company A, company B, or company C, it's actually being stored back into the table as 1, 2, or 3. So if you wanted to display the name of the shipper instead of the number back in the orders table, you're going to have to create a separate table called shippers, which we actually have here in this database, that's going to store the shippers' names. And then in the orders table, and let me switch over to the orders table, you're going to have to make the ship via field here in the orders table a lookup field that goes back to the data in the shippers table. And that's already done here as well. Okay, so in our form, I want to show you how to create an option field for the payment type here of credit card. And I'll also show you how to update the payment type field in the orders table to make it a lookup. All right, so let me switch over to design view. And I'll just do a little maintenance really quickly. I don't need this shipped country field, so I'll go ahead and get rid of that. In this case, because all of our products are being shipped to the US. And what I'm trying to do here is just make a little bit more room for my option group. So I'll take my shipping fees and my taxes, just select those and drag those up a little bit. I'll get rid of my notes field down here at the bottom. I'll take paid date and drag that down a bit and get rid of this payment type altogether. All right, so now my option group for payment type will fit into this area here. Now, I got rid of and moved around some fields, but what you could also do is just make your form a little bit bigger. All right, so to get started, I want to make sure that I'm in the Design tab here for the Form Design Tools. And this little XYZ with the box around it, that's that option group. So I'll go ahead and click on that once, left click to select it. Now, when I come down here into my details area, you'll notice now that my cursor is being followed by an option group with a little crosshair. So I'm going to left click and drag to make that a little option group. And when I release my mouse, the wizard pops up. So first I have to put in my option names. So the payment types here are going to be cash, check, or credit card. So I'll go ahead and type those three in, cash, and then I want to hit tab, not enter. Check, tab, and credit card. All right, I'll go ahead and click on next. Do I want there to be a default option? No, no default. You know, because sometimes people forget to actually click on something else when a default selection is already selected. So I'll go ahead and say, nope, I don't want a default, and click on next. Here is where I'm assigning the values. And again, it has to be a number. I can't have cash in there. Although that would be really nice, I can't have check or credit card. All right, so I'll click on next. And what do I want to do with this data? Do I want to save it for later? Or do I want to store it in a field in the underlying table? And I want to store it in a field, and I want that field to be the payment type field. All right, I'll click on next. And here I can format what I want my option group to look like. So do I want option buttons? Do I want check boxes? Now, I think checkboxes are a little bit misleading because usually when you see checkboxes, that means that you can select multiple options. And again, remember, for option groups, you can only select one option. So I'm going to change that back to option buttons. You can also choose toggle buttons there. Those are nice. I'll change that back. And the style, if I want a shadowed style, sunken, and so on. I'll leave that as etched and click on next. And here it's asking me for the name or the caption on the option box. So I'm going to change that to payment type. All right, I'll go ahead and click on finish. And there it is. Now let me go to form view to see how this looks. All right, so I can click on cash, check, credit. Well, it seems to be working here, but let me go ahead and double check the orders table to make sure that it's working there. So this is record number one, and it's set to credit card. Let me go to record number two, and I'll set that to cash. All right, let me go back to record number one. So let's take a look at the orders table and scroll over to payment type. Yep, so I can see here that my payment type for the first one is set up to 3, which was credit card, and the second one was set up to number 1, which is cash. Now remember, it's storing the number here, not the actual text of credit card or cash, but I can show you how to fix that. Now, in order to go in and make a change in the design view of the orders table, I have to make sure that this form is closed. So I'll go ahead and right mouse click on it, close, and save. So I'm going to scroll down till I can see payment type, and I'll give a click there. Now I want to take a look at the lookup tab. You see here that it's a value list, which means that someone just came in and typed in credit card, check, and cash when they originally created this table. Well, what I'll do first is I'll go ahead and get rid of the row source, and then I'll come up here to the data type, and I'm going to change it from short text to a lookup wizard. And on this first window, it's asking me if I want to look up values in another table or query, or if I want to type the values in. Well, typing the values in, that's how it got there in the first place. So I want to look up values in another table. And here I have a table called payment type. And it's really just the number 1, and then cash, the number 2, and then check, the number 3, and then credit card. So I'll go ahead and click on next. And I will scroll down to find my payment type table. Click on next. I'll bring both of those fields over and click on next. I'm not going to sort it. I'll click on next. There's my different payment types there. The key column is hidden. It's the ID column. I'll go ahead and leave that hidden and click on next. And whether or not I want to give it a name, I am fine with the label of payment type, and I'll enforce data integrity. So what that means is someone can't just go into my payment table and delete different types of payment there without getting a warning. All right, I'll go ahead and click on finish and switch over to my data sheet view. Scroll over a bit. And there's my new payment types. So when I take a look at the form, I'll go ahead and open that up. I called it orders option group. And let's say that I go to the third record and I add in that was paid by check. Go to the next one and add that was paid in by credit card. This is record number 4 here. Now when I head back onto the orders table, there we go. It added it in. I can also come here, click on the drop down, and I'll choose cash for record number 5. Go over to my options group form. Go to record number 5. And you can see here that it's set as cash. So the communication here goes both ways. All right, so option groups. It's always best to set them up before you start entering in information into your table. But they're not at all hard to set up. It's just a matter of going to the design tab, going to the option group option, dragging it down, telling it what labels you want for your options, just remembering that the label is not going to be stored. It's going to be the value in the label that's stored. So in the underlying table, you'll see 1, 2, 3, 4. You have to create a lookup that'll go back to a table that already exists that's going to define what 1, 2, 3, and 4 are. Now I've added a document to the resources section for this lecture, so absolutely take a look at that. But option groups make it really easy for users to go in and add information to your forms that go back to your tables.